In this tutorial, we'll show you how to create a sales planning business process and how to enable features for advanced sales forecasting in Oracle Sales Planning Cloud. As the administrator, you'll need to complete each of these steps to set up advanced sales forecasting. Let's get started with creating an application and enabling features. If necessary, create a Sales Planning Cloud application. Include the application name and description. Select the start and end year, first month of the fiscal year, and the weekly distribution within months. Finally, select the application's main currency and optionally choose multi-currency. Review your selections and create the application. After successfully creating the application, click Configure to enable the features you want. If you're using both Advanced Sales Forecasting and Quota Planning, enable and configure Quota Planning before Advanced Sales Forecasting. In this example, I'll just enable Advanced Sales Forecasting. Based on your selections, dimensions, drivers, forms, and other artifacts are created. You can plan by territory or resource. The lowest level in each hierarchy represents a sales rep. With territory, you can integrate with Oracle Engagement Cloud's territory management. With resource, you can integrate with Oracle Engagement Cloud's incentive compensation management. Note that if you're using both quota planning and advanced sales forecasting, the planning basis is selected automatically based on how quota planning is configured. You can also include dimensions for customer accounts, product, and geography. These dimensions can be specific to advanced sales forecasting and don't have to match the selections in quota planning. Under planning time granularity, you can choose to plan monthly and weekly. With weekly planning, you can select the week-to-month mapping independently from the selection made during application setup. The week-to-month conversion lets your users perform their forecasting weekly while providing the flexibility of easily reporting on monthly totals. You can also enable rolling forecasts. This creates a rolling forecast scenario that you can use to continuously forecast over a rolling range of time periods. Select predictive planning to perform time series statistical analyses on historical data to predict future results. Users can copy these predictions into forecast and what-if scenarios. If you're also using quota planning, you can enable integrations to use target quotas in advanced sales forecasting. Selecting this feature creates a data map between quota planning and advanced sales forecasting and lets you run integrations to move targets from quota planning into your forecast scenario. Finally, if you need additional dimensions, you can enable them here. You can also rename dimensions. Review your selections before proceeding. After advanced sales forecasting is enabled, sign out and sign back in again. Notice that advanced sales forecasting has been added to the home page. Before you can use the predefined forms, you'll need to configure time periods, import dimension members, load historical data, set user variable values, and prepare forecast data. Now that you know how to create and enable advanced sales forecasting, please watch the next video, Configuring Advanced Sales Forecasting in Oracle Sales Planning Cloud. Thanks for watching.